never-before-seen amateur footage captures the impact of the devastating tsunami that hit Japan 1 year ago.
I looked in my rearview mirror and saw an even larger wave than the one in front of me.
As it rose higher, you could see people who weren't able to escape.
I felt the terrible power of nature. I was not expecting that nature could be this dreadful.
Filmed by eyewitnesses and amateur photographers, caught up in the disaster unfolding around them.
It happened really fast. I didn't expect the water to come all the way to where I was.
You weren't just running. You were running for your life.
Japan tsunami caught on camera.
I kept saying in my head, please stop. Please stop now.
The Chile earthquake happened the year before I was born. My father decided they should evacuate. While they were evacuating, they got overtaken by the tsunami, and I lost my older sister. She was 9. My sister died. My mother had given birth to her relatively late in life, but she said she wanted one more child. So the next year, I was born. My whole life I've been told I was born because my sister died in a tsunami.
When the earthquake hit, I had left my house and was driving. So I wasn't sure if it was an earthquake or just a car. But when I saw the way people were moving and the building shaking, I knew it was an earthquake.
All of a sudden, the room started shaking. I grabbed my computer so it wouldn't fall and waited for the shaking to stop. I thought for sure a tsunami was going to come. I started yelling at people in the office to run to safety as soon as possible.
It was just an instantaneous decision I made to get the camera. I filmed inside the office, but because the shaking continued, I
didn't seem like a tsunami was going to hit. I don't think anyone knew.
While I was filming, I still didn't think about the tsunami. A fire truck was driving around the area, telling people to evacuate. The local people began to head for higher ground.
When I looked at the river, the water rose up so fast. It was like it was next to me. It all happened so quickly. The river flowing backwards and the tsunami overflowing into the city.
From the point where I saw the tsunami myself to the point where I got to the top and looked down at the town, it was completely different. There was so much water, it felt like it all happened in an instant. The sound of buildings crashing against each other, the sound of wooden structures crunching. There's just no way to say it. It's difficult to comprehend as a reality. Was it fear? It was like a film. The people who had been calmly working just an hour earlier, the people who lived here, in just seconds, all of that was gone.
I don't really remember the sounds as the water rose up, but I remember thinking how much I wish it would stop. There's nothing you could do but pray to God. We couldn't do anything in the face of such immense power. There was nothing to do but yell and scream. We couldn't contain ourselves.
Because my family has a particular connection to tsunami, when this tsunami came, I decided I wanted to record it for posterity. So I climbed the stairs halfway up the building and started taking photos. The first thing that got sucked up was my shed. I thought, it's just a shed, oh well. At least the house is okay. And just as I thought that, the house went with it. The things I was seeing were completely unimaginable.
When we started running, we assumed that we would be able to outrun it. But what happened was that the wave completely swallowed us up. I was desperate. Fortunately for me, soon after I was swallowed by the wave, a roof drifted towards me and went under my body
as if it was trying to pick me up. So, I was on top of the roof, and the wave took me all the way to the high school. People who were by the school saw me and pulled me down.
Most of the residents were already at the emergency evacuation centers. I was on the fire truck and was directing people over the loudspeaker. Once the waves hit the bottom part of the levee, the water shot up the side very suddenly. I probably only had 5 seconds or so to get away. If I got on the truck 20 seconds later, I don't think I'd be here today. I knew my duty was to direct people to evacuate, but I didn't turn off the camera. I'm actually not really sure why I kept filming. We had a levee that was 5 meters tall that we thought could protect against a tsunami. We based all our evacuation areas and exercises on this assumption. As a firefighter, as the father of a child, I can never forgive the fact that I let children die. I let elderly die. I can never forget. We knew